students must be equipped with one pewter cauldron and may bring an owl, toad, or cat. Can we find all this in London, Hagrid?
If you know where to go, welcome to Diagon Alley, Harry.
Wow! Look at all these shops! There is one selling cleaning supplies, Hagrid. Brooms!
Those are not for cleaning, Harry. They are racing brooms.
Wow! Nimbus 2000. I wonder how fast it can go. Look, there is the Owl Emporium. But how am I going to pay for these, Hagrid? I don't have any money.
There's your money, Gringotts the Wizarding Bank. Why don't we take a look around Diagon Alley and explore the shops?
That's a great idea. Do you know how much these shops make each year? I guess it depends on the number of factors and the types of products they sell.
Blimey, Harry, I've not thought about that. Maybe cheaper products sell better?
Dunno, maybe we can use data visualization to figure this out?
I think they teach data viz at Hogwarts. What do I know? I'm just a gamekeeper.
Do you have information on the shops, Hagrid?
Hang on, here it is. My friend at Gringotts gave this to me.
So we have Ollivanders, the maker of fine wands. The apothecary sells potion making supplies. Broomsticks we've seen before. The Owl Emporium selling owls and owl treats. Florian Fortescue selling ice cream. Flourish and Blots, a bookshop. Madame Malkin's Robes for All Occasions, selling school uniforms and dress robes. And Quality Quidditch Supplies. What's Quidditch, Hagrid?
It's a game that you play on a broomstick, Harry. You'll see when you get to Hogwarts.
Oh, I see. Let's begin by installing three packages. Tidyverse, Cable Extra, and GG Sci. Tidyverse is a collection of R packages for data wrangling and visualization. We use the Ggplot 2 package in Tidyverse.
What's Cable Extra and GG Sci?
Cable Extra is used to create tables, and GG Sci has a collection of color palettes inspired by colors used in scientific journals.
Can we use Cable Extra to visualize the dataset, Harry?
Totally! We can use the Cable Styling function to get a glimpse of the data table. Now, let's begin by creating a plot using the ggplot function. Then, we use the geompoint function to add points to the plot.
What's a geom?
A geom is a geometric object that a plot uses to represent data. So, geompoint is used to make points in a scatter plot. We can create a scatter plot of the total revenue per item versus the price of each item. Take a look, Hagrid.
That's cool, Harry. That's a lot of galleons. Based on this plot, it looks like if the price for an item is cheaper, the total revenue per item type is higher.
Interesting. That could be because cheaper items are more affordable and therefore sell better. We can use the team BW function to create a clean looking graph, and the XLab and YLab functions to modify the X and Y axis labels.
Looking better, but what do these points refer to?
We can use the aesthetics to add color to the points to represent each shop. Aesthetics is a visual property of the objects in a plot. It can include color, shape, and the size of the points. The GGSci package has some really cool color palettes. We can use the Scale Color Futurama function to apply a color palette based on the Futurama show.
I wonder which points represent the Owl Emporium.
Here you go! The Owl Emporium data points are in light blue. It is also useful to see how many items per item type are available in the inventory. We can do this by adding size to the aesthetics.
Looking great! One of the ice cream flavors must be low in stock.
Finally, we can split the plots into facets. Facets are subplots that display a subset of the data. We can use the facet wrap function to split the plot into shops.
Come on, Harry, we're running late. Let's go to Ollivander's to get your first wand.
A wand? Yes, please. Can I get a Nimbus 2000 next?